Welcome everyone to this episode of Get It Right, and you are in the right place. This is the show where we find out just how much our two contestants know about our advanced magazine articles. Let's meet them.
Hi, Mom. Hello, everyone. I'm Luke, and I work for the National Fire Protection Association.
Hello, Luke's mom. My name is Jenny, and I work at a local community center.
Well, are you ready for an earthquake?
No.
No.
Well, then this article is for you guys. It's called Earthquake Preparedness. Oh. Now, viewers, are you ready should an earthquake strike? We hope so, because if not, then this is also the article for you. Well, let's begin today's game, contestants. Now, this article tells us that we should be prepared or to be self-sufficient with no power, no outside assistance for a minimum of 72 hours and up to 14 days in a worst-case scenario. Now, what does the phrase worst-case scenario mean?
It's a noun. It means the most unpleasant or serious thing that could happen in a situation.
Yes, that is right, Jenny. Something we hope doesn't happen. Okay, well, what does this word or phrase with the following definition? What is the word? To be prepared, to be used, or to act immediately?
Oh! Is that the phrase ready for action?
No, but it's something very similar in meaning.
I know this. Is it the phrase to be at ready? At the ready?
At the ready? At the ready?
At the ready.
Yes, that is correct.
You weren't ready.
Well done, Luke. Well, toward the end of this article, it asks the reader whether we know the threats and risks unique to our area. For example, hillslides or hillsides prone to landslides or streets that are likely to flood. And do we know how to avoid them? Now, what does the word prone mean?
Oh! I know this one. Prone means to be likely to show or have a specific negative quality.
Wow, yes, Jenny, that is right.
Yay!
And that makes you the winner of this episode of Get It Right.
I'm the winner.
Well done. Viewers, join us next time on
Get It Right.
Just like I did.